This is weird.
It is a little bit weird. These bony projections, we call them bone spurs, so I try to not refer to them as head horns, even though our children, their behavior might make
right.
you think otherwise.
Right, so if you ask, is my child growing horns, you might be thinking of like a demon toddler, but
absolutely.
we're talking about older kids.
We're talking about older kids, and we're talking about the back of their head. These researchers from Australia did a study, and essentially they looked back at old x-rays for a large group of people, and they saw that these bony prominences were prominent for this age group, which was different. We knew that older populations had a little prominence in the back of their head, and we're talking about 50, 60, 70, 80-year-olds. What was new about this study was that the number of the young people that had this prominence.
So do they believe that what's causing it is sort of like that looking down at a tablet or your phone, and then where exactly are the projections?
So the projections are right in the middle. We call that the occipital region of the skull, and it is thought that the neck strain could in fact be causing the bone spur. However, the other half of medical scientists don't want to race to judgment that
sure.
it's all due to technology, but certainly more research is needed and something that we need to pay attention to.
So is it one of those things where maybe if we're talking about education with posture, I mean, do you hold the phone? Because it's not going away.
Absolutely. So, and that's what we have to realize as those who come out with guidelines. The phones aren't going away. What we do recommend is that if you're going to hold the phone, it should be up like this as opposed to down like we all do. Usually we're on our phone because we're not supposed to. We don't want anyone to see us. But the good posture is going to be up in front of you. Also, we like to reiterate, we don't like any more than 2 hours a day looking at a screen. We know that's really hard. There's a lot of curricula or on a tablet, but we want to try to keep that screen time down.
And since you're a pediatrician, I know we're talking about older kids and young adults, but when would you say is a good time to introduce a smart device?
As pediatricians, we really don't say there's a good time. However, we think less than two, they really shouldn't be getting that much screen time. I know that's hard. I have a child that is less than two who loves YouTube, but we think that probably three or four might be a great age to introduce them to a tablet. We just want to create healthy behaviors in our youngest of people.
For sure, and yep. avoid them growing any bony projections.
Right.
Horns. Yeah, exactly. All right, well, thanks for coming in. It's always good to see you.
Thank you so much, Megan.
All right, Dr. Ashanti Woods is at Mercy Medical Center.